Thank you for being here for our first Camerata Women Quintet concert
of the new year. We are excited to be a sort of new group this year, so I'm going to take a second to introduce everyone, and then we're going to speak a little bit about the pieces we're playing for you tonight. My name is Dr. Jenna Gardner, and I'm the horn professor here at Western. My colleagues on stage are Dr. Soo-Yun Ko on flute, Dr. Paul Chinnan on oboe, Dr. Andrea Baker joins us for the first time this year on bassoon, and Professor Eric Ginsberg, who celebrated a birthday yesterday. Happy birthday. At this time, I'm going to ask Dr. Baker to come and talk to you a little bit about our first piece on the program.
All right, so our first piece on the program is by 20th century French composer Henri Tomasi, who is very well known for his wind writing. He wrote a lot of really wonderful concerti, chamber pieces, especially featuring woodwinds and brass. And the piece that we're playing tonight, which we'll be doing four movements from the Five Dances, was originally actually written for chamber orchestra and then was reduced by the composer. So the first movement that we'll be playing, which is the first movement, it's Dance Agreste, which means pastoral or rural. And this will be featuring heavily the oboe, which often has the privilege of being featured in kind of pastoral movements. We will be skipping to the third movement, which is the Danse Sacrée. And now this one has a beautiful low solo that was originally written for the tuba, but it has been taken over by the bassoon in the wind quintet version. And it's quite lovely. Moving on, we have the Danse Nuptiale, which is a wedding dance. So it's quite light and upbeat. And then the final movement is a complete contrast to that, and that is the Danse Guerrière, and that means warrior dance. And it is a fierce warrior, and the bassoon gets to play the part of the ferocious, high-pitched just warrior that is really off to the battle, and you'll definitely hear that. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
honorable mentions. We're getting these pages set up. But I just wanted to mention, in the next piece, the range actually goes out of what is typical for the bassoon. It goes down to a low A instead of low B flat. And so to accomplish this, we put in an extension into the instrument. So you'll see me take this in and out throughout the work. So I know there's always questions, so I figured I would just let you know before the piece begins.
I have some prepared remarks. Cigan is a gypsy, Hungarian gypsy, and it's a pejorative term usually referred to the Romani. Valerie Coleman is a composer who got inspired by a Palestinian oud player, a short-necked lute played across the Middle East, North Africa, and Central Asia. So the music is inspired by Middle Eastern scales and fortunately includes improvised clarinet cadenza. And that was an interesting experience to do. I tried to use some of the material that was in the piece, and then I started to think about Hungarian music, and so there are some allusions to other composers that you might recognize. And so, see if you do.
Thank you. and teaching tradition. The desire to impact lives through education marks our Western identity. We believe every student with the hope to succeed deserves a chance at our institution. We're invested in honing each student's individual strengths to turn that hope into promise. Our commitment shows in everything that we do. It guides our faculty with empathy. It grows our students with courage. It moves each of us with purpose. In Macomb and Quad Cities, all walks of life meet to share cultures, ideas, and aspirations. Together, our students welcome new perspectives, helping them bring true value wherever they go next. Whatever the next challenge or change we face, our fighting spirit strengthens and evolves. With fortitude, we remain devoted to our vision. Brave and loyal, we stand as Leathernecks. For our students, for our region, for our state, and beyond. And when we stand together, we stand up for what matters, going forth as one. And that unity takes us far beyond what we've ever imagined.
Rooted in teaching tradition, the desire to impact lives through education formed our Leatherneck way of life.
Here, a Leatherneck doesn't salute to how things have always been, but instead envisions a world that is full of possibility. At Western, a Leatherneck is courageous. A Leatherneck is a creative, outside-the-box thinker, bold and big-hearted. A Leatherneck is someone who trailblazes ahead into the unknown.
From around the world, to right here in Illinois. In every sex, shape, color, or creed, we stand together as Leathernecks, fearless and loyal.
At Western, we believe every student with the hope to succeed deserves to thrive at our institution. We're invested in honing each student's individual strengths to turn that hope into promise. Our commitment shows in everything that we do.
In Macomb and the Quad Cities, all walks of life meet to share cultures, ideas, and aspirations. Our students bring a new perspective and a forward-thinking mindset that will help them wherever they go next.
Whatever the next challenge we face, we strengthen and evolve. With fortitude, we remain devoted to our Leatherneck fighting spirit.
When we stand together, we stand up for what matters, going forth as one. And that unity takes us far beyond what we ever imagined.
The world needs Leathernecks like you.
Western Illinois University, Leathernecks don't just blend in. Our purple stands out. Our students are innovative, creative, and resilient. At WIU, there's limitless potential, with campuses in Macomb, the Quad Cities, and online. Visit wiu.edu/potential to become a Leatherneck and get an education that stands out.
At Western Illinois University, each student brings their own unique background and unlimited potential. You work side by side with compassionate, encouraging faculty who connect you to personalized learning experiences and give you the opportunities to map your own future. Your potential, our purpose.
At Western Illinois University, limits are meant to be pushed. Because the best change happens when people think in new and unexpected ways. At WIU, you'll experience a world where your presence matters, where your ideas take flight, and your determination opens the door to possibility. At WIU, we create a world that's brand new.
Welcome to the University Union. Serving as the center of campus life, the Union is a great place to hang out with friends for lunch, meet with a student organization, attend events, or take advantage of one of our lounge spaces to study or relax in between classes. The University Union is here for you.
Grit. It's that thing inside of you that ignites passion and empowers you to envision a world full of possibility. At Western Illinois University, Leathernecks are made with this grit. It starts here, in this field, in this room, on this court, and in this lab. We refuse to blend in because our purple stands out.
I would not be able to go into a master's program if I did not have this financial assistance. Obviously, undergrad, I did take out some loans, and I've got quite a few student loans behind me already. And so the only reason I was able to continue my education is because of graduate assistantships covering my tuition and helping me pay a monthly wage and helping me just, you know, pay for my apartment and my groceries. Like, it is the only thing keeping me in a master's program right now. So I am extremely grateful for it. So I would absolutely love for in the future to go into the academic field as well. I want to be a college professor. That's one of my biggest goals. I love the age of students working with, and even now I get some experience like teaching in class and stuff, and so that's really helped me want to go into the academic field. But then I also want to continue designing professionally. I do work as the costume designer at the Clinton Area Showboat Theater as their resident costume designer and shop manager, so I like having the professional environment mixed with the educational environment. As a graduate assistant, this to me is the most important type of academic help that I can get, because it's not just us earning money to do our school, it is continuing part of our learning. So as part of my graduate assistantship, I work in the costume shop, which is what I'm trying to do for the rest of my life. My learning doesn't stop just because class is over. My draping and our stitching and our designing, we do as part of our assistantship as well. So instead of stopping at the end of the class and then going to wait tables, we are continuing and earning our living here and earning our way here, but still continuing our education. And so that's really important to us as designers, because it's so hard to get that experience, and you need that experience to go into your field. So to be able to do both things at once is what really keeps us employable, honestly, but also it just, you know, lets us be better designers and better technicians and better students in general.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.